Before Bridgette Bardot, there was Martinе Caroll. Frequently cast as a cool seductress, her real life was often more dramatic than her films. She married 4 times in 18 years and was once briefly kidnapped by the notorious French gangster Piеrre Lоutrеl, aka Pierrot Le Fou. In this video, we'll be looking at the life and sad ending of Martinе Caroll. But before we begin, don't forget to watch this video to the end, hit the like button, and subscribe for more interesting videos. Beginnings. Born Marie-Louise Jean-Nicole Mure in Saint-Mon-Val-de-Marne in France, she studied acting under René Simon, making her stage debut in 1940 and her first motion picture in 1943. She frequently was cast as an elegant blonde seductress. During the late 1940s and early 1950s, she was the leading sex symbol and top box office draw of French cinema, and she was considered a French version of America's Marilyn Monroe. One of her more famous roles was as the title character in Lola Montez in 1955, directed by Max Ophüls in a role that required dark hair. However, by the late 1950s, roles for Caroll had become fewer, partly because of the introduction of Brigitte Bardot. Discovered by Henri-Georges Clouzot, in unbilled film parts from 1941, she subsequently caught the eye of Henri-Georges Clouzot, who hired her for an upcoming film with a working title of The Cat, based on the novel by Colette, but the project was scrapped. Nevertheless, she did attract attention in the movie Wolf Farm, which takes advantage of her photogenic beauty and ease in front of the camera despite a limited acting ability. She was the pinup goddess in the early 40s. A pinup goddess and support actress throughout the 40s, Martine also appeared on the stage of the Theater of the Renaissance. She began a torrid affair with actor Georges Machal, who was married to actress Danny Robin at the time, a relationship that ended disastrously, and she attempted suicide by taking an alcohol and drug overdose and throwing herself into the same river. She was saved by a taxi driver who accompanied her there. Later works. Continuing on with post-war French filming, she co-starred in such movies as Bеforе 3, 1945, The Queer Assignment, 1945, Trente et Quarante, 1946, Voyage Surprise, 1947, Sextette, 1948, I Like Only You, 1949, A Night at a Honeymoon, 1950, the title role in Dear Caroline, 1951, and Adorable Creatures, 1952. She scored her first box office blockbuster hit with the French Revolution epic Caroline Chérie, 1953. Without a doubt, the success was prompted by her semi-nude scenes and taunting kittenish sexuality. From there, she was off and running. Her film romps were done tastefully with an erotic twinge of innocence and gentle sexuality, plus an occasional bubble bath thrown in as male bait. Her array of costumed teasers included the title role of Lucretia Borgia, 1953, as Lysistrata, Daughters of Destiny, 1954, Riviera, 1954, the title role in Madame du Barry, 1954, the title role in Nana, 1955, The French, They Are a Funny Race, 1955, the title role in Lola Montez, 1955, and Defend My Love, 1956. Several of the above mentioned films were guided and directed by her second husband Christian Jacques, her husband from 1954 to 1959. They later divorced due to professional conflicts and long separations. A true feast for the eyes and one of the most beautiful actresses of her time, Martine tried to branch out internationally in films in the late 1950s. Unfortunately, Bardot had already taken over the top French sex goddess pedestal, and Martine's fan base diminished. She co-starred with Van Johnson in the crime drama Action of the Tiger, 1957, but it was met with indifference. She immediately returned to French-Italian films The Foxiest Girl in Paris, 1957, The Stowaway, 1958, Venetian Honeymoon, 1959, 10 Seconds to Hell, 1959, and Atomic Agent, 1959. Sad ending. Despite her fame and fortune, Martine Caroll's personal life was filled with turmoil that included a suicide attempt, drug abuse, and 4 marriages. Crazy Pete and Martine Caroll met in a Paris nightclub during his Gestapo years. Her beauty made Caroll stand out in any crowd, and she was used to the attention. Whether she had any idea who he was, we'll never know. But eventually, whether by free will or otherwise, she left the club with him. She was kidnapped by gangster Piеrre Lоutrеl, also known as Piero Le Fou, or Crazy Pete, albeit briefly, and received roses the next day as an apology. Ironically, the unhappy details surrounding her suicide attempt renewed the fascination audiences had with Martine up until that time. Martine Carol was married four times. In 1949, she married her first husband, former American actor-turned-restaurateur Stephen Crane, previously Lana Turner's husband, married in 1948 and divorced in 1953. Her second marriage was to Christian Jacques, film director, married July 1954, divorced in 1959. She got her third marriage to Dr. André Rouvier, a young doctor she met in Martinique, Fort-de-France, married August 3, 1959, divorced in 1962. And finally, she got married to Mike Elland, an English businessman, married in 1966 until her death. Substance abuse. Martine was last seen on screen as Martine Grant in 1967's Hell is Empty. Problems with substance abuse and a severe accident severely curtailed her career in the 1960s. She continued with such films as The Battle of Austerlitz in 1960 as Empress Josephine, plus Violent Summer 1961, The Counterfeiters of Paris 1961, and Beach Casanova 1962. She made her last film in 1963, which was released 4 years later as Hell is Empty 1967. Depressed, Martine turned alarmingly reclusive, as a third marriage to French doctor André Rouvier also soured by 1962. One last marriage to fourth husband Michael Elland, an English businessman and friend of first hubby Steve Crane, seemed hopeful. But on February 6, 1967, final exit. Martine died of cardiac arrest at age 46 in the bathroom of a hotel in Monaco. Her husband discovered her. Newspapers hinted at a possible drug overdose, but nothing was ever proven. She initially was buried in the Père Lachaise Cemetery, Paris, but her original grave was violated after the press reported that she had been buried with her jewelry. Martine Caroll was then buried in the Grand Jean Cemetery of Cannes. Whether you're talking about her kind heart or just looking at the medium Martine portrays in her movie, Martine's memory isn't going to clear in a hurry in the history of Hollywood. And that is it in this video. Before we go, don't forget to hit the like button, share with your friends, and subscribe for more interesting videos.